Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from around the world. Our headlines: ICC Chief Prosecutor announces formal investigation into war crimes in Palestine. UN reports over 50 killed and 1,700 arrested so far amid crackdown in Myanmar. US House of Representatives passes police reforms bill amid call to defund the police. And finally, activists organize protests across Chile as anti-government resistance intensifies. In our first story, the International Criminal Court will launch a formal investigation into Israel's possible war crimes in Palestine. Chief Prosecutor Fatah Bensouda announced a decision on March 3rd. The decision comes a month after the ICC ruled that it had legal jurisdiction to investigate the occupied territories. Bensouda had first stated in 2019 that there was reasonable basis to launch an investigation into war crimes being committed by Israeli forces. The ICC will now examine the war crimes committed in the occupied Palestinian territories starting from June 13, 2014. The investigation will cover Israeli aggression during the war in Gaza, otherwise known as Operation Protective Edge. Over 2,500 Palestinians, a majority of whom were civilians, were killed during this war. As per Palestinian and UN estimates, another 11,000 were left injured. The investigation will also include illegal Israeli settlements in the West Bank and the confiscation of Palestinian land. Israeli air raids and missile attacks have destroyed at least 18,000 Palestinian homes in Gaza. 73 medical facilities have also been destroyed in the area, which has been under siege since 2006. Israeli attacks on Palestinians during the Great March of Return protests in 2018 will also be investigated. Rocket attacks in Israel by the Palestinian groups in Hamas will also be examined. Israel and the United States have both opposed the investigation. The Israeli government is reportedly also working on a law which will ban any cooperation with the ICC by its citizens or officials. The UN has reported that at least 38 protesters were killed in Myanmar on March 3rd. The death toll was announced by Special Envoy to Myanmar, Christine Scharrer-Bergner, during a press conference. Footage and local media reports have shown police firing live rounds into the crowds and even using machine guns in some places. Protesters were also attacked using slingshots, and there is a video of police beating up a group of medics. Use of excessive force, smoke bombs, stun grenades, and tear gas has been reported in multiple places. While some estimates have varied, Wednesday's killings have pushed the death toll of Myanmar's anti-coup protests near 50. Rights group Save the Children has also reported that at least 4 children have died in the violence. Demonstrations continued on March 4th as people gathered in streets across cities. Myanmar now reported crowds of tens of thousands of people in the town of Myingyan. Protesters in Yangon set up barricades made of bricks, while naval forces were also deployed in the area. Medical workers continue to join the protests and provide on-site care to protesters. Eyewitnesses have stated that the police opened fire and used tear gas to disperse the protesters in Yangon. Military planes were also spotted flying over Mandalay. Security forces have also continued to carry out mass arrests, including journalists. UN Human Rights Chief Michelle Bachelet has said that 1,700 people, including 29 journalists, have been detained so far. In our next story, the US House of Representatives has passed a police reforms bill introduced by the Democratic Party. The George Floyd Justice in Policing Act was passed with a majority of 220 to 212 on March 3rd. The act is named after 46-year-old Floyd, who was murdered by police officers in the city of Minneapolis last year. The bill will authorize state and federal officials to investigate police conduct, including the use of excessive force. It also includes provision to ensure the use of body and dashboard cameras by on-duty officers. It seeks to create a registry of police misconduct and amend qualified immunity for the police. The legislation will also ban practices such as no-knock warrants and chokeholds. Data Project Mapping Police Violence has reported that law enforcement officers were responsible for 1,127 killings in 2020 alone. Black Americans were disproportionately targeted and made up 28% of the victims. Only one Republican Congress member voted in favor of the bill in the House. The legislation has been passed days before a former police officer accused of Floyd's murder is set to go on trial. Derek Chauvin will go on trial on March 8th, facing charges of second-degree murder and manslaughter. In the meantime, the legislation will now head to the U.S. Senate for a vote. While the Democrats hold the tie-breaking majority, delays in the voting procedure are expected. Despite the bill's broad mandate, however, many have stated that simply reforming police will be insufficient. The mass protests following George Floyd's murder had intensified demands for the abolition and defunding of police. Activists have argued that similar reforms bills passed previously in various states have been unsuccessful in ensuring substantive change. For our final story, we go to Chile, where protests against right-wing President Sebastián Piñera have intensified. Trade unions, social organizations, and student groups have announced a series of protests and strikes over this month. People are demanding the resignation of President Piñera and the release of political prisoners. Here is a video feature on the protest held in Santiago earlier this week. your time for today. We'll be back tomorrow with more news from around the world. Until then, keep watching People's Dispatch.